Hello, in today's video, we shall discuss in detail about inflorescence. By the end of this video, you will have a clear understanding about racemose inflorescence, cymose inflorescence, their different types, and also about special types of inflorescence, namely Cyathium, Verticillaster, and Hypanthodium. Let us start with the introduction to inflorescence. The inflorescence in a flowering plant is the mode of arrangement of a cluster of flowers on a floral axis. The stem holding the whole inflorescence is called the peduncle. The major axis above the peduncle bearing the flowers is called the rachis. The stalk of each flower in the inflorescence is called a pedicel. Inflorescence is categorized into two groups on the basis of the arrangement of flowers on the main axis and also on the timing of its flowering. The two distinct groups are racemose or indefinite or indeterminate and cymose or definite or determinate inflorescence. Let us start with racemose inflorescence. In this type of inflorescence, the main axis continues to grow and produce flowers laterally. Racemose inflorescence is characterized by acropetal succession, that is, the young buds and flowers are arranged at the tip, while the older ones are found at the base. The order of opening of flowers is centripetal, that is, the peripheral flowers mature first and then maturation proceeds towards the center. Example, mustard, brassica campestris and radish, Raphanus sativus. Next is cymose inflorescence. In this type of inflorescence, the main axis ends in a flower. The lateral axis also terminates into a flower. Thus, the growth at the apex is limited. Cymose inflorescence is characterized by basipetal succession. That is, the young buds and flowers are placed at the bottom while the older ones are found at the tip. The order of opening of flowers is centrifugal, that is, the older terminal flowers always open earlier than the lateral ones. Example, night jasmine. By the way, if you are getting some value out of this video, please like and share the video so that all of us can learn, unlearn, and relearn together. Also, please consider subscribing the channel and press the bell icon to get instant notification of all the upcoming videos. Now, let us learn about racemose inflorescence in detail. The different types of racemose inflorescence are as follows. With the main axis elongated, the different types are raceme, spike, spikelet, catkin, and spadix. With the main axis shortened, the racemose inflorescence are corymb and umbel. With the main axis flattened, the racemose inflorescence is known as capitulum or head. Let us learn about each one of them. First, raceme. The main kind of racemose inflorescence is the raceme. It is an indeterminate inflorescence with pedicellate flowers along the axis. The lower or older flowers have longer stalks than the upper or younger ones. A compound raceme, also called a panicle, has a branching main axis. Example, gulmohar. Next type is spike. The main axis is elongated, unbranched, with unlimited growth. Flowers are sessile, without pedicels, and developed directly from the stem, as in barley. The lower flowers are older, open before the upper ones. Example, amaranth. Next is spikelet. Each spikelet may bear one or a few small flowers attached to a central stalk called racila. There are a pair of empty glumes at the base of the spikelet, and just above them is a flowering glume called lemma with a flower in its axil. Opposite to the lemma is present a small bracteole called the palier. All the parts of the inflorescence is clearly shown in the diagram. Spikelet is characteristic of the grass family. Next type is the catkin. It is a type of inflorescence in which the main axis grows indefinitely. Catkin may be erect or pendulous and bear unisexual flowers only. Example, mulberry. Next type is the spadix. This is also a spike consisting of thickened, fleshy axis. It is surrounded by large, brightly colored bracts called spathes. This type of inflorescence bears cluster of sessile, apetalous, unisexual flowers. The spadix is found in monocotyledons only, example, banana, palm, etc. Next is Corymb. It is a racemose in which the pedicels of the lower flowers are longer than those of the upper flowers, so that all the flowers are brought to the same level. The main axis is comparatively short. Peduncle is well developed. Arrangement of flowers is acropetal. This type of inflorescence is common in members of the mint family. Next is Umbel. Peduncle is reduced to a point or shortened so that the pedicels are of the same length. All flowers radiate out from a common point. Arrangement of flowers is centripetal. Whorls of bracts is always present, forming an involucre. If the umbel is unbranched, it is known as simple umbel. And if branched, it is known as compound umbel, as seen in carrot. Umbel is characteristic of coriander family. Next, we come to capitulum, otherwise known as head. The peduncle is somewhat flattened to form a receptacle. It bears a mass of small sessile flowers called florets on its surface. Whorls of bracts form an involucre. The florets are arranged in a centripetal fashion with outer older flowers and inner younger flowers. The florets are of two kinds, ray florets and disc florets. The ray florets are long, strap-shaped, while the disc florets are tubular. A head or capitulum is characteristic of sunflower family. If both ray florets and disc florets are found in the same capitulum, the capitulum is called radiate. It is known as discoid when only disc florets are present. It is called ligulate if only ray florets are present. Next, let us study the different types of Cymose inflorescence. First, uniparous or monocacial cyme. In this type of Cymose inflorescence, the main axis ends in a flower. At a time, single lateral branch arises from the peduncle and each one ends in a flower. There are two forms of uniparous cyme. They are helicoid cyme and scorpioid cyme. Helicoid cyme is a type of determinate inflorescence in which the flowers develop on one side of the axis, forming a sort of helix, as in begonia. Scorpioid cyme is a type of Cymose inflorescence where the lateral branches develop on alternate sides, forming a zigzag pattern, as in cotton. Next is biparous or dicacial cyme. In this type of inflorescence, the peduncle culminates into a flower. It produces two lateral younger flowers. There are three flowers. The oldest one is in the center. This pattern of growth continues as seen in pink jasmine, night jasmine, etc. Multiparous or polycacial cyme. In this type of inflorescence, the main axis culminates into a flower and forms a number of lateral flowers. The oldest flower is in the center. Example, calotropis. Let us now learn about some special types of inflorescence. First, Cyathium. This inflorescence is found in Euphorbia. 4 to 5 bracteoles together form a cup-like structure called involucre, possessing nectar-secreting glands. The inflorescence is apetalous, with both male and female flowers. The involucre encloses a single female flower, which is reduced to a pistil present on a stalk. It is present in the center and at the base of the involucre. There are numerous male flowers centrifugally arranged. Each reduced male flower consists of a single stamen. The female flower matures first and then the stamens. Next, we come to Verticillaster. It bears a cluster of sessile or subsessile flowers in the axil of a leaf. At each node of the stem, two axillary opposite cymose inflorescence develop on either side. This kind of inflorescence is found in basal family, example Osimum. Last, Hypanthodium. The inflorescence has a fleshy receptacle with a hollow cavity that has an opening at the apex known as ostiole. The flowers develop towards the inner wall of the hollow cavity. The male flowers are placed at the top near the apical pore, and the female flowers with a long axis develop at the base of the cavity. This type of inflorescence is seen in fig, banyan, peepal, etc. A fruit developed from Hypanthodium inflorescence is called cyconus. The receptacle grows, becomes fleshy, and forms the fruit. It encloses a number of true fruits or achenes which develop from the female flowers lying within the receptacle. So today we have learnt about different types of inflorescence in detail. I have some practice questions for you. Please share your answers in the comments section below. You can pause the video and write down the questions if you like. Thank you so much for your time and participation. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please consider subscribing the channel and press the bell icon to get instant notification of all the upcoming videos. Also, if you want to discuss any particular topic in biology, please mention that in the comments section below. I'll see you there. Goodbye. All the best.